This obelisk is of your hardest stone. Kick it.
Hit it.
Yell at it.
Break!
Corbin, cut it.
Move back.
This is part of the weirding way that we will teach you. Some thoughts have a certain sound, that being the equivalent to a form. Through sound and motion, you will be able to paralyze nerves, shatter bones, set fires, suffocate an enemy or burst his organs. We will kill until no Harkonnen breathes Arrakeen air.
Stilgar.
Muad'Dib.
My name is a killing word.
First and foremost, I want to give all praises to Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai. I want to thank apostles and elders of Adam Manbet and Great Wellstone, the two camps that I tend to listen to, for bringing me into this truth, and the Akim, the various people who are not in camps, who are posting on various social media, Twitter, YouTube, and anywhere else, and the people that I know publicly and privately, for bringing me into this truth and keeping pushing out this word. I wanted to give a quick talk about the word of God, how powerful it is, and I feel like we don't really understand the power, but that's because we live on a carnal, or we exist on a carnal plane, so it's very hard to understand the word of God, how powerful it is. Hebrews 4 and 12, for the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than a two-edged sword, piercing even unto the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of thoughts and intents of the heart. That is to say, the word of God can break a man's soul. So think about it, which would you rather have broken? Your bones, your skin? Like, rather have a cut or broken bone, or have your soul and spirit split? That's how powerful the word of God is. It's sharper, it pierces, but it can also cause the joints and marrow to come apart, but not on a carnal level, if you say the word of God can cause somebody's body, the prophecies, many times in the Bible where someone has been prophesied to become sick, to become ill, and it can cause their joints and marrow, the bones, the bodily structure, this is what they're talking about, to fall apart, but at the same time to come together. Just want to go to Genesis, the very, very first, because This is where it all begins, really, because Genesis is where it all starts, because Genesis chapter 1 verse 1 in the beginning God created the heaven and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. So this is before there was form, you know, well, the heaven and the earth was built. So there was some form, there was space and there was the planets, but there was complete darkness, right? And God said, let there be light. So when God wished to create light in the universe, he didn't smash two atoms together. He didn't physically try and create accelerate particles or cause explosions. He said, let there be light. And from that, maybe from the spiritual level, where God has sent out his intent, you know, the word caused the light to happen. Maybe that's what caused the particles to accelerate, or explosions to happen, or things to coalesce. But the point I'm trying to make here is, at the start, when God wanted there to be light, he said it. And then he gave names to it. So, let me carry on. And there was light, and God saw the light that it was good, and God divided the light from the darkness. And God called the light day and the darkness night. So after the word is the name. You know, or the name is high. Both the word and the name is high. And the evening and the morning were the first day. So God creates on the spiritual level first, in his word, which is his intent and his spirit. And from his word was the whole universe created. So if from his word the whole universe was created, what cannot be done within the universe through his word? You know, and there's the name. He names things. Again, gives words, puts words to them. And through the conveyancing of names, there's great power. I think I'm going to shut off there. I'm just going to shut off there. So all you carnal people picking up guns, trying to destroy this one, you know, and destroy that one with weapons, it's just not the way. This is a spiritual battle, and the word is like a two-edged sword. Let's see if we can get some precepts on the word before we shut off, actually. Alright. I'm going to follow the Spirit. I'm going to shut off there. Praises to you, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, Shalom.